Hey guys, Mike Hayden here. In this video today, what I'm going to run through is the importance of VRM with Victron. And what I really want to get the point across in this is how to see your energy consumption, why it's so important to record your data. Because if something does go wrong and you don't have any history, it's actually really hard to figure out what's going on. I just gave an example yesterday to a customer saying, hey, things are not doing so good. And I logged in, had a look, and I was like, do you have three batteries or four? She said, I've got four batteries. And anyway, we worked it out and she only had three batteries. So it's so important to have the data and have everything registered online so you can see the history. Because when I log in and see that history, I could see, well, only three batteries were working. She thought it was a problem, but three batteries were working. She thought she had four, but she only had three once we opened the cup and had a look. So having that history online really, really helps to diagnose problems and things like that. So simple math calculations, all that one was. So yeah, and if you're someone that doesn't like having things connected to internet all the time, completely understand. And even if you do have things connected to internet all the time, I'll use the color control as an example. These what pretty much all we used to do and use in systems and installs with Victron. Now in the bottom of these things here, they take a little SD card. So if you just basically buy an SD card and shove the SD card in there, just one of those little micro SD cards, so it's the baby one that goes in the bottom. If you shove that in the bottom of your Victron, it's going to record all the data. And then when you connect it to the internet, it'll pull all the data off and save it on the VRM for you. And then you can turn the internet off and you're done. So it's going to be a good way of saving your history and get all this data without losing it all and not understanding all your usage and things like that. So it's really important to do. So cool. All right. And if you do have a servo, which is one of these things here, the color screen's a little bit harder to see where it is, but on the servo, it's just on the bottom. They're normally a little bit easier to see where everything goes. You just whack the SD card in there. So if you don't have your system online, it's going to record all that data and you have it all online to be able to access later on to see some things. So cool. So I'm going to jump over now to the VRM portal. And just so if you do not have a VRM portal already, remember, go to Victron. You want to go over here to the Victron, just victronenergy.com, and just go to the VRM portal and go and actually register. There's other things here for installers and things like that. So just go there, log into the Victron VRM. And also as well, if you don't have the Victron, something you're thinking about and you want access to check out a few systems, you can actually easily jump onto our YouTube channel and go to our mailing list, shoot us an email, and we'll actually shoot you a link to a couple of different systems that we have that you have access to, and you can actually look at these data. Now, okay, so we're going to pick on a system here. This is an off-grid system. Some things with this system here, if you're already a Victron user, and I'll show you a few things that have dropped off in this system because it is 5 a.m. in the morning here in Australia. I'm shooting this video at the time. This here is when you just go to the dashboard. It's just going to pretty much show you the generator. If there's nothing in here, you know, your generator's not working. If you're a grid-connected customer, it's going to say, you know, the grid. If you've got both, some systems have hybrid or generator, this will only show what is active AC input. So if the grid's connected and it's on, it'll show it. If the generator's on, it'll dump the grid and put the grid down the little box down the bottom and show you what the generator's doing. So this here is to show you what's going on with incoming power. If you are grid connected and you're feeding back, it's going to show minuses, which is showing energy going back to the grid. As you can see, here's the AC loads. This is all the 240 loads. And over here, we've got what's coming out of the batteries. Now, in this situation here in this system, what you'll actually see at the moment is actually the wrong way around. And there's a bit of delay and stuff, and so stuff's a bit slower. But as you see, the heavier the loads and things like that, you'll see there's more coming out of the batteries than what you're actually using because it's counting the losses, and you'll actually use more kilowatt hours out of your batteries than what you actually use in your AC loads over here because there's losses in the inverter. The bigger the loads, the more losses and things like that. So, and also as well, the more you do of a night, there'll be more losses than what you do of a day. So that's those two inputs there. And this here is your PV charger. Now, some people will see you've got a PV charger and of a daytime. So at the moment, we've got the PV chargers off because, you know, it's the middle of the night. And then you'll also have the PV inverter. Now, if you've got the PV inverter there all the time, so it's on 24 hours a day, that basically means that likely the installer or the company that basically supplied the system to use an energy meter in the system. So basically, which is for reliability, which will keep it connected. Now, we used to always use them when I was basically involved in selling, design, install, and solar systems. We'd always use the energy meters. But the last few years, things have got so much more reliable. They're really not that required with the Wi-Fi and things like that. So actually, look here, the AC loads have jumped up. So it's definitely coffee time here at the Lawtons. So as you can see here, we're actually pulling more out of the batteries than what we're using. You see there's bigger loads because they're the losses and things like that. So yeah, so that'll show you what your PV charger and PV inverter is doing. And another common thing, and I'll show you with Wi-Fi, when we use the PV inverters, we connect them via Wi-Fi, what'll happen of a day is these AC loads will be zero, and you'll say, hey, Mike, you know, my PV inverter's not working. Your AC loads are zero, and you'll see the batteries are getting charged a lot more than what the PV charge is doing. That's simply that the PV inverter's dropped off the Wi-Fi, and it can't see the information, the data going back over to the batteries. So it's just, yeah, learn, understand, depends what inverter that you've got, of how to reconnect it to the Wi-Fi. If you can hardwire things, great. Some inverters, and it's just every location. You know, I've had systems Wi-Fi'd for years and things are great on the outside of a shed wall, and it all of a sudden drops out. You go out and have a look at the customer's place, and they put these big brand new steel cabinets right up on the inside of the garage. It looks amazing. And you're like, that's why your Wi-Fi's dropped out. So think about things like that. And if you can hardwire important things, that's why we always use the energy meters, is because it's reliable and it doesn't affect by Wi-Fi. So something to think about. It does add a bit more complication to wiring systems. Myself personally, I built one recently and I wired it backwards. So it reads minuses. So something to think about. It's easy to make mistakes. Okay, that's basically your dashboard and what you'll see here. Now, some other quick things. This is an off-grid system. But up here, if you are a grid-connected customer, you're going to have ESS and some other things there, which I'll go into another video. And this one here, we actually haven't set the auto start for the generator for this one here because we've got a brand new generator coming next week, which is pretty exciting to put in this system. So, but that there's a button. Once it's all set up, you can actually go in and auto start your generator with your relay. Now, we'll see this one here. The last 7 days, we've set nothing back to the grid or into generator. So 0 kWh has gone back out that way. If you're a grid connected customer and you're feeding back to the grid, that's what you would see. So this system has produced 58 kWh of solar and they've consumed 68 kWh in the last 7 days. What we want to do is go down to consumption and we'll see here what you've actually produced and consumed from solar and batteries. So we'll have a look here is basically from batteries, you know, from this day here, they use 4.72 kWh and 6.75 from solar. We'll pick another day. This is a big day. 9.54 kWh from solar, from batteries, apologies, and 3.29 from solar. So you can see that you can see last 7 days. You can click on this here, it'll take it back. You can do a lot of date ranges and stuff like that. What I'll show you, if you really want to work out, so say for example, one of the things to think about, if you really want to see how much battery energy you used the night before, because these things will actually read from sundown to sunup, and we don't know what that time changes every single day. And when they actually read a day, it actually reads from midnight to midnight. So if you just go into the Victron settings and say, hey, look, give me the last 24 hours, it's going to read, you know, midnight to midnight, or give me the last 2 days. We'll actually have a quick look in this here. This is pick the data from midnight through to midnight again. So you'll just see that data for the last 2 days from a midnight through to a midnight, which basically doesn't give you true battery consumption overnight out of your whole batteries, because it does. You want to see the sundown to sun up. So the way I normally do it, go yesterday here. As you can see, we're still seeing we're seeing the morning and we're seeing the afternoon. So let's just see today. We'll click on today and I'll show you what it means by today. As you can see, we're going from midnight through to the morning. So what I do, go to custom range here. We'll go to yesterday. We'll pick a time. And let's just say about 1600 is normally a good time to do. And that comes through the current time right now. We can have a look. So as you see, yesterday we started on batteries at 1600. Let's actually change that back a bit more because we want to make sure we're seeing all the PV. Cool. We started using batteries nice and early yesterday. The weather mustn't have been too good. Let's go to 1 p.m. Here we go. So as you can see, from 1 p.m. yesterday, is the system actually started pulling from batteries. So normally it's going to be around that 4 to 6 p.m., but obviously yesterday the weather wasn't too good here. So it started pulling from batteries. And as you can see there, you've seen, you know, even that there through this morning, the consumption from batteries has only been 4.7 kWh. And as you can see, it's been a little bit from solar because the solar was still trickling. It basically looks like here that, you know, the solar's cut out, so very minimal. And then the weather's come back up of an afternoon, some cloud cover, something's gone, and the solar's trickled a little bit in there. So as you can see there, so if you really want to see your data for that overnight, that's what I'd highly recommend. We'll actually go back a let's go pick another day so we can see. Let's go to the, we'll do the 9th to the 10th. We'll go from 2 p.m. 10th up to, we'll say 7 a.m. the next morning. Should give us a good idea. Oh, we're missing a bit of data there. So maybe some Wi-Fi or something dropped out there. So let's maybe go back. We'll pick another day. Let's go to the 3rd to the 4th and see what happens there. 3rd to the 4th, 2 p.m. to 7 a.m. There we go. That's what we wanted to see. So this is a good example. So as you can see here, we're just dipping into batteries, basically. So at 2 p.m. there. So obviously, another day where the weather wasn't too good in the system. As you see, the system's still just trickling in there till about 7 o'clock at night. 6, 7, it's pretty much gone. But this is a really good one to have a look at and see how much you've consumed out of your batteries in total. So we've got 6 kilowatt hours there that the customer here has actually consumed directly from batteries at that point of time. Cool. Okay, so some other things I want to show you. So that's basically how to get consumption out. Now, the next thing I want to go to more of advanced. So if you really want to understand a lot of details and a lot of data, I'm just going to change this to the last 7 days. We'll do the last 2 days so it looks better. You want to jump over to advanced here. And there's up in the right-hand corner, you've got your widgets. So basically, you can come in here, grab all the data out of here. You can see what that you want to see in the widget. So if you want to add one, you go in here and go, right, I want to see the system AC consumption. Tick that. We'll come back down here. We'll get rid of that. We come back down here. And it's now added the system AC consumption into that there. What do we got here? It's a date range. We've got the last 2 days. So as you can see here with the battery voltage and current, so that gives an example of the battery voltage. You see here it's gone right up, overcharging the battery, and then it drops back down to float. And then that trickle there overnight, the charge out of the battery. So this is really handy to basically see all the ins and outs and basically battery amp hours consumed. One thing a lot of people get confused with batteries is when your consumption, there's a difference between amp hours out of batteries and then what you actually use through your inverter, because there's those losses there, and it's something to take in and understand and think about. Now, this is great because this will tell you the exact amp hours, and also the faster you take energy out of a battery, the more energy you're going to use, because it's the more heat there is, the more losses, so you don't get as much storage out of the battery. So the slower you can take energy out of the batteries, the more storage you're going to get out of them, basically. Now, this is really bad with lead acid batteries and nickel ion batteries and things like that, the older style batteries. It's not as bad with lithium these days, but it is the exact same. I'll give you an example, my electric motorbike. When I used to leave home and I'd go for a ride, I could charge it to 130K range. I'd get out of it my first trip out of home. But once I'd hit the road and start charging, if I tried charge it full on the road, because I was charging it so fast, because you want to get it done and dusted and keep going, I'd only get about 100K range because it was so hot. We'd get the battery voltage almost full and you just have a load of losses. So the faster you charge batteries, it's the same thing. And that's why we have this, we call it, you know, the bulk, you know, it charges flat out. And then we want to reduce into float and let it slowly trickle charge to let that heat dissipate from the battery and just top that battery up to full. So overnight, you get the full usage out of your battery, is something to think about. So there's lots of different widgets in there, guys. I'm not going to go into in details about this one here, but if you want to add them and see what data that you want to do, there's a load of different things you can see in there. Now, a couple of other things I want to show advantages of actually having with VRM if it's actually online and connected. Now, you've got alarm logs, and I'll use this one example. There's lots of alarms in here because we actually don't have the auto start generator in here. So we've got the alarm set in this system. It gets at, when it gets to, I think it's like 47 volts or 48 volts, something like that, it'll trigger a low battery alarm. But that doesn't mean the system shuts down. It's just letting the customer know, hey, the batteries are getting low. Just be careful. Now, having this online, you actually have all this stuff automated and actually sent to you as an email. I won't go into how that set that. That's a video for another day. But it's a really good thing. One of the other really good things Victron has come up with is also that if you do have the system online and does drop offline, you can receive an email and things like that. So I'm going to do some more in-depth videos of how to set all that sort of stuff up. If you do want access to the more detailed stuff, like I said before, jump over here. If you go to that YouTube channel and just subscribe, and you'll get emailed all more of the technical stuff. I don't really do the real in-depth technical stuff here on YouTube because there's a lot of effort to make these videos and do that sort of stuff, and they don't get a lot of views because they're really technical. So yeah, so if you do want to get into more of the depth of technical stuff, just jump over here and shoot us an email and get on our list so you get access to that. Now, some other useful things in here is basically if you have done a DIY install, or even if you haven't, upload some photos up there. It makes it really easy for people trying to help you with assistant and look at things. Whack some photos in here so you can see what's going on. If you just want to go to question or say, hey, Mike, what's this, what that do? If you've got photos there, it makes it really easy. You can add notes, so they're recorded in here, so you can whack some notes and stuff in there to keep for history. It's a good way to keep your notes. It's all linked to your system. And now the next thing I want to show you is, I'm not going to go into this in details, but reporting. And this is really cool. So what you can actually do is actually, you can actually see if you were connected to the grid. So we'll actually do this one here. We'll go back. We're still for 14 days. Change it to dollars. And so if we were connected to the grid, basically, you know, we used, instead of using, this will actually take the data from your system. So you actually have to have a system for this here. But if we're connected to the grid, in Australia, the prices are about 0.35, although 0.36. Energy prices have actually just gone through the roof. And I know a lot of people at the moment are still on old contract price. And I've seen some crazy prices as high as 50 cents here in New South Wales of prices going up. So this is a good example to go, right, generate comparison. That in these 14 days, the customer would have spent $53 on energy buying from the grid. So you can actually see how much your system saved. If you've got a generator, you can also whack a generator in there and see how much energy that you've used from a generator. And look, I've done lots of jobs over the years. You know, the Daintree is a great example where the guys actually don't have solar up there. They use generators lots. And you can actually see the beneficial price. And it was actually really interesting when it was the Daintree, how it works is they run a big generator of a day, because they want big loads, heavy stuff, and yeah, they run a big generator. Then overnight, they flick to a smaller generator to save fuel and quieter and things like that. So a lot of the consulting and stuff I did in the Daintree when I went up there was more about, okay, generators of a day, charging batteries, and we're running batteries overnight for that quiet, peaceful time, trying to work out the cost and analysis. And this would have been great back in the day when I went up and did that project. It would have been awesome because, yeah, in the Daintree, it's hard to put solar panels up because a lot of people build their houses or their buildings in the shade, under the trees, out of the sun to keep the places cool. So it's hard to put panels up. Then also you get cyclone season and stuff like that just come and rip everyone's panels off. So, yeah, cool. So, all right, guys, I hope this has been helpful. And like I said, if you want access to some monitoring data and things like that, this is actually, I've got two monitoring datas at my house, some public sites you can actually have a look at and check out the information. You can stalk me and see how much energy I'm using. If you just shoot us an email, easiest way is jump over to YouTube, you'll get on there and you'll just shoot us an email and let us know that you want the data. And you can actually have a look at my two systems at home. My Victron system currently at the moment is off right now as of shooting this video, making some changes and doing some cool stuff, which is pretty cool. And I didn't get around to putting everything back together in time, so it's okay. But you'll actually get access to my system privately. You can see my Victron system, what I do, and I do some crazy stuff here with mine. And also you get access to, this is a hybrid grid connected system. This is a solar edge system, so you can actually have a look at that and check that out. Cool, so guys, yeah, if you got something out of that and you really like it, appreciate, share it with a friend or family. And yeah, if you haven't already, get on and subscribe. And if you did get something out of this video, we'd really appreciate the like. Like I said, if you want more access to some private systems and see some data, we actually do have a lot of different systems we can share with you, the information, so lots of different platforms. You can log in, have a look, and see what the platform, the system looks like, how it produces energy, and how people use energy. And sort of, if you're looking to go off-grid or go solar, it's a really good way to see, okay, this is how other people use their energy and how will you use your energy in those situations. So just jump into the YouTube channel and go over in here, click on the link and put your email address in there, and we can send you some data out. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time. Thank you.